Soul Station in 5 words. Entertaining, exciting, velvety, intimate, fun.
Everybody's the coolest, babe, but they don't give you chills like me. And everybody's got bullets, babe, but they can't blow your mind like me. And they may think that you're foolish, babe, to keep you coming back to me. But we know what the truth is, babe. It's just a thing that I can do better, baby. It's just a thing that I can do better, 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 better.
We like that tempo? Alright, that sounded great. I like how that started too. Let's try that again. Like maybe Mark, you start that bass line with Michael.
The idea behind the whole series of the Soul Station. It's just good, comfortable music. If you like soul music, you're gonna like this. I wanted to make an album that you just put on and you leave on. I think through all the different genres of music I've done, at the center of it is a soul, because I consider myself a soul singer. I feel music very intensely, and when I sing, it's a very committed and full on, you know, it takes my whole body, my whole, you know, all my attention, all my focus. It's stirring, I know that. I feel stirred myself. And I think that's what soul music is. It's that type of singing that can sort of stir an emotion in you.
1, 2, 1. If you ever change your mind.
I sort of came across the whole idea for the Soul Station when my manager gave me an amazing book, the biography of Sam Cooke. You know, I'd heard of Sam Cooke, but I really didn't know his story. And I was just captivated by it. His life is just an incredibly fascinating life. He had this real strong presence. I just said, you know, I just want to do these songs. I just want to, you know, as I listened to them, I was like, these are just great songs. I want people to hear them. And I want to sing him. And, you know, the Soul Station idea was sort of born.
I was born by the river in a little tent.
I've learned a lot as a producer. You know, one thing I've learned is that the magic, the real magic in songs comes from musicians, great musicians. They're the key to making great music.
A lot of times a good producer just knows when to stay out of the way. And I mean, that's really what this project is good about. These musicians are just unbelievable. The songs are just incredible. So let's just let this thing just unfold naturally. Right in, we'll do one time through, and then without the turnaround, and I'll start the hook, like a 4 bars.
Without the turnaround,
just sort of like a little intro, yeah.
I guess producing and performing are really quite different. I feel blessed that I can do both because they're both amazing. If I had to choose one, I think it would be performing, just because I just love it so much. I've always loved being on stage.
Just me in the crowd, man. Just me in the crowd. I'm here, man. to the music. On the radio. Having a party. Everybody's swinging.
It's funny. I mean, I started off my music career trying to always reinvent music in a sense, you know. In the Philosopher Kings, we did that a lot. We would try to create songs that had never been created before, songs that, you know, brought together different elements that had never been brought together. And I think at this point in my career, I'm much more into creating songs that sound like they've already been written. I mean, those to me are my favorite kind of songs right now.
Everybody's the coolest, babe.
Everybody just feels it. It's just really comfortable. It's really natural. And I feel blessed that I've been able to make it, you know, to be honest. I've been, I feel really lucky to have been able to create music like this.
But we know what the truth is, babe. It's just a thing that I can do better, baby. Good night!